Hero Motocorp electric car likely to launch in the near future. So we are in 2021 and Hero Motocorp does not offer even a single electric motorcycle in their portfolio and continues to sell lakhs of pollution motorcycles that cause more harm than good. And yet, Gadiwadi thinks that they will launch an electric car soon. The pollution vehicle media is at it again, creating nonsensical speculation when it comes to EVs just for the sake of clicks and views. Upcoming Maruti electric car for 7 lakhs. There was speculation recently that Maruti scrapped its Wagoner electric, and yet the senseless Maruti electric car gossip continues. This time Motor Octane says that a 7 lakh electric car from Maruti is upcoming, even though we've not heard any news from Maruti itself about this. At this point, we are numb with the absolute drivel being churned out by the pollution vehicle media when it comes to EVs. Consumer acceptability does not exist. Maruti chairman continues his anti-EV propaganda. R.C. Bhargav, the chairman of Maruti, is at it again. He continues to show his anti-EV agenda by spewing a lot of dinosaur propaganda. First, he says that lithium cells are only available in China, when many companies we know use cells from Japan, Korea, the United States, and so on. Then he says that there is no lithium cell manufacturing unit planned in India for the next 5 years. But that is more nonsense, as Toshiba, Denso, and Suzuki are setting up a cell manufacturing plant in Bhargav's own Maruti complex in Gujarat. Then Mr. Bhargav says that lithium is only obtained from one country, China. He conveniently ignores the MOU signed by the Indian government with Argentina for the procurement of lithium. Mr. Bhargav also says that small electric cars cannot be built and are not practical because they are expensive. I guess he hasn't heard about the Strom electric car or the Mahindra Atom. Let's be honest. Companies like Maruti won't launch small electric cars because then no one will buy their pollution cars, and that will result in less money earned via service by dealers. This is all just one giant scam being fed to the mainstream media, who is happily lapping it up. They are complicit in this negation of EVs in India. Autocar India says that even a 350 km range electric car is not practical. So let's get this straight. Autocar India, which has been bashing EVs ever since the launch of the indigenously developed E2O electric car back in 2013, now says that more low-range EVs are needed in India, when there actually were low-range 100 to 150 km electric cars. Autocar India laughed at EVs, saying that the range was too low. Now they've done a complete volt fast and are saying that the 350 km range offered by some EVs is not practical and that having less range is better. I guess Autocar India won't be happy until companies find some way to make electric cars run on petrol. It doesn't matter if that's impossible. As long as Autocar India is concerned, where there's petrol, there's a way.
Abhishek, thank you for that gossip. And oh my God, what's happening? Last month, we were all praise about Maruti. We thought they had something in the pipeline, then they were throwing up smoke screens. But after looking at this article and what their chairman, Mr. R.C. Bhargava, says, I think they are totally oblivious to the fact. They do not understand how the world works. In today's global economy, when anything big in any country will affect every other country, he's going on to say that what Tesla does doesn't matter to India. In fact, it will matter the most to India. Let one gigafactory come up nearby and that is going to flood the market with batteries. So this guy has no understanding of what the future has in store, and I'm afraid they're going to go exactly the same way as Kodak did when they were so arrogant about their photography business. So mainstream media has always been iffy in its fact checking, and here's one more example where they haven't even cross-questioned Mr. Bhargava. He says there is no plans for a battery manufacturing plant. There are big plans for a very big battery manufacturing plant backed up by Suzuki and Denso, and Maruti is going to get the lion's share of the batteries. So this is something which is really not done. So another thing that he says is that India is dependent on only one country for supply of lithium, which is not true. India recently entered into an agreement with Argentina because they are massive lithium ore suppliers, and there are many more lithium ore suppliers which we will get in touch with. So Mr. Bhargava also goes on to say that the conditions are not right for electric cars, which is absolutely untrue. There are many fast charging networks coming up. There are EVSEs being put up between important cities. So highway driving is possible. And even cars with a range of as less as 200 kilometers can do intercity travel, as we have done ourselves, which took longer in those days because we didn't have fast charging. And coming back to the topic of small electric cars, that is what will revolutionize city travel, and that is definitely what is required. Mahindra came out with the E20, Tata had the Tiago, which could definitely be made into something more practical and affordable. And you know guys, even back in 2013, Mahindra Reva launched the E20 two-door electric car, which was a fantastic addition to the Indian EV space. And right now in 2021, Strom R3 is out, which is again a small car, a two-seater. And we have Tata Tiago, which has been showcased. So it is definitely possible to launch a small, affordable electric car for the Indian masses. And a company like Maruti, with its massive resources and engineering potential, can easily do this. But they don't want to do this. They're afraid that they'll lose their existing market of ICE cars, of these Wagonars, Espressos, Altos, the smaller ones that they've got on the roads. And this accounts for major market share of these companies. And they are just dinosaurs who don't want to change. So all in all guys, we feel that these guys totally lack the passion. They don't understand technology. They don't really understand what the people want. He says that there is not enough demand in the market, but that's totally false. Look at Tata. They've launched the Nexon. They've got overwhelming response from the people. And if Maruti were to launch a good quality EV, which is affordable for the mass market, or a larger or a more expensive variant as well, it would definitely be successful. So here we have this mindset of these people who are happy with the business the way it is, and they just want to keep going on without having to go through the trouble of innovating and changing and making something good which will make the people's lives better. And over here, I would blame the mainstream media as well, who is going hand in hand with people like Mr. Bhargava, not even correcting him, not even asking him the pointed questions that need to be asked, because they are just both of them equally complacent. So next, Abhishek goes on to talk about the article by Autocar India, where this guy wanted to go to Goa and he would have picked up the keys to his Kona, but he decided to go in his Hector instead. So he got discouraged because he felt it was too long a distance that, and he would have to charge somewhere in between. Now the thing is, just one fast charger on the route and that would have made his day. And he should have mentioned that in the article, because it is so getting easier and easier, and fast charging networks are coming up. They are going to be as easy as a 20 to 40 minute plug-in and you're at your destination. On the way back, you get coming down the ghats, regeneration, and you don't need to charge again. So there are these kind of petrol heads in Autocar India who don't really understand the way technology is moving and flowing. They are stuck in their gears and in their oil, and they're addicted to that. And they are unable to see a better future coming forth. But they are still covering these in their effort to grope somewhere and stay relevant. So because electric cars are getting popular, because they are the unbeatable champions, these guys have to publish something about EVs. So here they are putting up a fluff article and trying to say things about stuff that they don't really understand. Alright guys, so that's it for the gossip section. I hope you enjoyed it. And for a new dose every month, please check out pluginindia.com/electricvehiclegossip.html, and we'll put the link in the description below for you guys to easily access it. We have a lot of myth busting over here, and a lot of anti-EV propaganda is taken care of. We put it straight. We talk to you about what's being said that's wrong and what are the actual facts. So guys, in the end, thank you so much for watching. And do let us know in the comments below what you think about Mr. Bhargava, what you think about Autocar, what do you think about Hero MotoCorp doing its stuff. And until next time, take care.